call meeting. It is ironic that most of the same people and commissioners who are now expressing so much concern about Vidant closing the Pungo District Hospital are the same people who were Vidant's cheerleaders when we were trying to decide whether Vidant or community health systems would be best for Beaufort County. The closing of the Pungo District Hospital proves that Vidant is about perpetuating their business by controlling the northeastern North Carolina health market. Studies have shown that costs are always higher and service is always less, but there is little or no competition in the service area. Had community health systems have come to Washington, there would have been an opportunity for Pungo to have associated with the Beaufort Hospital. That association, along with Community Health Systems Hospital in Martin County, would have created a medical provider group capable of competing with Vidant. That competition would have improved health services and lowered medical costs. Now that Vidant controls health services by owning the Beaufort County Hospital, as well as almost all doctors' practices in the area, they are dictating medical service to our community. It is difficult for me to understand how any knowledgeable person or board of hospital directors could have entered into a contract that did not protect the Belhaven area public by requiring a reasonable level of service. Vidant has stated that they never promised to continue hospital service in Belhaven. This may explain why Vidant made the decision to close the hospital so soon after acquiring it. There was no compelling reason to make the Pungo Hospital successful by changing the business plan or the level of service. Vidant controls that market area and all the doctors in Belhaven work for them. Whereas the manipulation of those who are ignorant of the business of medicine is easily accomplished because of North Carolina hospital and medical law, those laws allow nonprofits to do their business in secret. Therefore, we resolve that our North Carolina House and Senate elected officials tear away the cloak of secrecy that enables unfair medical business practices by repealing the legislation that allows nonprofit medical business decisions to be made in back rooms and kept secret from the public. We urge our legislators to require both nonprofit hospitals and medical practices of all kinds be subject to the open meetings and public disclosure laws of the state of North Carolina. That's not going to do you any good, but it is desperately needed in North Carolina to stop these kinds of practices. So that's a motion.
I'll second.
Okay.
Billy. You want copies of this? Pass that
thing. Yeah, please.
I want to
Let me ask Billy to discuss that just as an attorney in relation to the nonprofits. Is this something we can do as a governmental body?
Yeah.
I have seen it.
Yeah, we can do it.
Sure.
We can ask for the moon not to shine, the sun not to come up.
Yeah, what
you just write down. What you got before you write down is the motion. The motion to bring it. And you can act on that.
Okay. Mr. Belcher.
Yeah, I agree with the premise that they should be subject to the open meetings law. I read all the articles in the News Observer when they did their study of hospitals in North Carolina, and the nonprofit hospitals in North Carolina leave a lot to be desired. And I would support your motion as far as that goes, but a lot of this stuff in here I can't support. I mean,
well,
if you will just take and make the motion.
The only thing that we're voting on is the motion, therefore we resolve.
Okay, that
just whereas and therefore.
I don't support a lot. I don't support several of the paragraphs above that.
Well,
no.
Therefore we resolve. That's the motion. The rest of that is just build up to get to the motion.
Actually, it's just one whereas.
Yeah. So your motion. State your motion.
Okay. Well, I begin with whereas on this piece of paper. Whereas the manipulation of those who are ignorant of the business of medicine is easily accomplished because of North Carolina hospital and medical law. Those laws allow nonprofits to do their business in secret. Therefore, we resolve that our North Carolina House and Senate officials tear away the cloak of secrecy that enables unfair medical business practices by repealing the legislation that allows nonprofit medical business decisions to be made in back rooms and kept secret from the public. And that's what happened in Bellhaven. We urge our legislatures to require both nonprofit hospitals and medical practices of all kinds be subject to the open meetings and public disclosure law. That's the motion.
I can support that. I would rather it start with therefore, but I guess I could.
You gotta have a whereas. One whereas.
Replacing the motion, just let it be stated that the whereas and the therefore are the motion in relation to the minutes.
Yeah.
Is there any discussion in relation to this?
I would offer that there is no such thing as nonprofits anywhere. I mean, nobody can stay in business if they don't make a profit. I think Dr. Herman pretty much said that the other night. I mean, when we gave away our hospital, there was a lot of talk about we need to go with a nonprofit. We need to go with a nonprofit. We should go with a nonprofit. You heard that ad infinitum. But there's no such thing as a nonprofit. It doesn't happen. There is no infinite pot of money anywhere, and I think that's being proved in Bellhaven. And it's going to be proved here in Washington. Things don't turn around up there. And it's going to be proved everywhere. There has got to be a viable economic free market for anything to work. Those with the best services and the best costs are going to get the people to come there, and those that don't have that are going to lose. That's the way free markets work. Now, having said that, there is no such thing as nonprofits in this America that we live in today. I don't actually believe in public-private partnerships anyway. That is tantamount to corporate welfare. So, I mean, that's a subject for another day, but there's no such thing as nonprofits. I would like to say one more thing when we do your resolution. The reason I didn't do a resolution, I stated it earlier, I just want to reiterate it, be abundantly clear. It's very important that we have your input as representative of these people, and that you put everything you want in there, and that we do as much of what you want in that resolution as we will all agree to. So we could write it before you leave. I think what you'll get today is a vote of this body, and I'd be more glad to make the motion, that we set upon creating a resolution, constructing that resolution, and that we hammer it out. It doesn't have to be long, but it just needs to be
done. It supports the necessity of emergency room services.
Yeah, whatever you want.
Has to be.
If we're all in agreement with that?
Continuous.
Well, we'll make that motion after we finish with this motion.
But are we going to be able to make a motion that is concrete, or do we need to have it flexible? We'll talk about it.
We'll talk about it after we do this. Commissioner Brins?
I second it.
Okay, you have no comment?
Yes, sir.
Commissioner Booth, you have any comments? Belcher?
I've had a vote.
Booth, you had yours. I call for the vote. Those that are in favor of the whereas, therefore, please raise their hands. Those opposed, the vote is 6-0.